What's up, YouTube? We're back with another video, and this is how to start a bounce house rental business with zero experience, because guess what? That's exactly what we did. We've never done this before, but we decided, hey, let's take a chance and let's do it.
And make sure you guys stay tuned to the end of this video, because we're gonna give you all the finances. We're gonna tell you what went into it, any tips, anything that we've learned over the past, month?
Yeah.
Month that we've been doing this, because we've almost made all of our money back.
3 hours later.
Doing our other business while doing this business. Just enough space.
And just enough time.
Whew.
This definitely ain't for the week.
It's not. You better be in shape if you want to do this. Tip number one, you better freaking be in shape, because this is not, it's not difficult, but you got to do some lifting. That's for sure.
The next day.
So this took a lot of work. We couldn't get the camera out because this was hard work. We brought this thing in here. This thing weighs like at least 400 pounds. That one over there weighs like 450. That one may even weigh 500 pounds. And then that one, the light one,
that's, I love
like,
that one.
That one's like 250, 300 pounds.
That one's
pounds.
So easy to move.
Yes, that one has gone out the most. But today we have all three units going out.
And the generator.
Yes, so we're busy. And we woke up early because we want Dunkin'. So that's where we're going next. Okay, so the job is done. We staked everything in the ground. We left the blower there. We did everything we could on our part, but we couldn't blow it up and get a nice video of it blowing up and everything because the guy didn't bring an extension cord. He didn't have the proper power. So in that case, he said, that's fine. I'm gonna go run to the store, get an extension cord, and I'll have it blown up. But now we gotta go to the next delivery. So third delivery of the day, we're on a time crunch. We gotta get this stuff done. And then we gotta pick everything up.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
We just pulled up and come to find out, this lady's not answering her phone. We are about 30 minutes early. She's not answering her phone though. Come to find out, we spoke with the office manager, because it's in this clubhouse of, I think it's like an HOA community. The lady had signed, she rented the pavilion, but the land next to it is not included. So even though she rented the pavilion, it's actually in the contract that they are not allowed to have inflatables. This is why it's so important to read before you sign something. Always read before you sign something. So unfortunately, it's even stated in our agreement that there is no refunds of the deposit unless due to extreme weather. So unfortunately, you know, this lady is not gonna get her inflatable and she's not gonna be able to get her money back.
Okay, guys, so they had a great time. It was a good party. And we made about $200 plus off of that rental because on my Square app, I turned it around for them and gave them the option to give us a tip. And we got like a $19 tip, guys. So that was pretty sweet.
I told him, and I'm the one that put the option for a tip on the Square because after working at the gym, working front counter for the gym for 2 years, I learned that always turn it around for a tip because if people are given the option to tip, a lot of the times they will tip. So made a little over $200 for that, which is awesome. Yeah. And now we have some downtime before we have to go pick up the other one.
2 hours later.
Last one of the day.
We don't have the appropriate dolly for this.
We left it at the house.
Okay. That's why that was such a struggle, but it's in there.
All right, guys, so just to go ahead and do a recap of what we made that past weekend. Saturday, we had rented out that one bounce house for $150. Sunday, we ended up booking all three units, but only two of them went out. So we still got one of the deposits from the, what was it, the Wave combo. Yeah. It was our combo unit. So we got the deposit for that for $175. We had the $150 for the regular bounce house, plus another $50 for the generator. For the Caterpillar, we ended up cutting that guy a deal because he was buddies with the first guy that ended up getting a bounce house from us. So we rented out that Caterpillar obstacle course for $150, totaling to $625 for that weekend of bounce house rentals.
So we're gonna tell you guys how we got started with zero experience. The first thing we did was we went to Facebook Marketplace and we bought a used, good condition bounce house. I didn't just go with the first one I saw. I was looking for a while, guys. So take your time.
He went with the first one he saw in person.
Yeah, but I was searching for a while, okay? I didn't want to spend...
It was his birthday present. That's
yes,
what I mean.
It was. But I didn't want to spend $1,500 on my first unit. I bought my first unit for $750, and I had to negotiate. The guy was originally saying $800, and then when we pulled up in person, we're like, come on. And he was like, all right, I can do $750. You can always wiggle around the price. You just got to know how to talk. You got to know how to negotiate. Right? So we went over there and it was in excellent condition. There was no rips or tears and we bought it for $750. We started with one. Then we went ahead and we started posting listings on Facebook Marketplace, on Facebook groups. We put it on Nextdoor. Anything that you can go promote your business for free on the internet, go ahead and put yourself out there. And then we got the signs. And by the way, if you need signs for your business, boom, it says it right there. One color, signed just like this, same size, $200, and that's my phone number right there. I will create the sign for you and I will literally ship it to your house as well. So free shipping as well. Hit me up. I got you. I built the boxing gym with these signs, the boxing business, so many businesses. I've saved other people's businesses that were about to run out of business and I hooked them up with signs and now they are on a waiting list with their clients. So
if you need signs, get signs.
Hit me up.
But the second bounce house, because yes, you ended up getting that like the same week. He said we got the signs, but really we got the other bounce houses and the signs. Everything was like within the same week.
Okay. Yeah,
it was all within the same week. Okay, so let's finances. So okay, we paid for the first bounce house was $750.
Yes.
The signs, how many signs?
We're gonna say about $400 for the signs.
$400 for the signs. Okay, so yeah, we're gonna add that in. So it's the Caterpillar one. So the Caterpillar obstacle course, we got a good deal on that.
Really
one.
Good deal. We got an inflatable dolly, right?
Not an inflatable dolly.
Well, that's what
a dolly for the inflatable.
a dolly for inflatables, right? It was custom made by this guy who was getting out of the business because he was gonna move away, right? So he basically, we got a really, really good deal on that unit. I seen that same unit somebody else was selling it for $1,500. We bought it for $400, guys.
Yeah.
And it was an older unit. It wasn't perfect, but we still rented it out.
It's good for like smaller kids, like toddlers and stuff. Yeah. That's a good one, like small obstacle courses, because a lot of parents, when they have toddlers or, you know, children under 5, they're not really trying to get a ginormous water slide, which neither were we, because those things are freaking heavy.
Yeah.
So we ended up getting that. So we paid $400 for that. Yep. And then how much
$50 for the little dolly as well. Well, not little dolly, the big dolly. We got that for $50.
We got it for $50, really?
$50. Yeah, he was hooking it up for real.
Yeah, he did.
Literally, we rented it out the same day.
The same day,
yeah. Because I posted it on Instagram, and then somebody hit me up for it. And that's another thing. Post on social media. I created an Instagram for it, and I started spending like $5 per day to boost it to people in my city. And I got bookings from that as well. And then the next thing we got that Wave combo for $900.
Yeah.
I negotiated that as well. They had that thing listed for $1,500. And I was like, $900. And they were like, no, come on, man. It's worth more. And I'm just like, $900.
The wife wanted it gone. So we ended up getting that. And mind you, everything came with blowers too. So blowers themselves, I mean, if you buy them new, they're what, like $250?
Yes.
$300? They're expensive. But everything ended up coming with blowers. So all of those prices, we had the blowers included in that.
And then we also spent $150 on that generator. We got it used, and that generator,
which we're gonna use that for our house anyways, like we're gonna need that regardless.
So in total,
so we said $150 for the generator.
Yep.
Hold on, we gotta do some quick math.
So we're looking about $2,650 in total for like what we spent to get into the business. Okay. And that was for all of our another $300 for the trailer. We got a trailer too.
We forgot about the trailer.
Yeah, so
we ended up getting a 5x8 utility trailer for like a stupid deal. It was like $300 for that. I don't even think we paid $300. It was like two. It was a weird number. We're just gonna say it was $300.
Yeah, $300 for that trailer, which we didn't need, but we used it.
Yeah. So the total came out to $2,950.
Yeah. So we'll say about $3,000 we spent to get and started with this business. We made that money back, y'all, the first month.
Yeah, we made
we literally made that money back.
But at the beginning of the video, we said that we almost made all of our money back, but by the end of the video, we made all of our money back already.
Definitely. That's how we got started with the business. Now, some tips, like I said, post on social media and get signs for the business, guys. That thing was blowing up. My phone was blowing up. People were booking in advance. And another tip, take a deposit. Always take a deposit. I bought a unit from somebody who was already running a business, and they said they didn't do deposits.
But
I don't know.
As you guys can see, with that one lady that she got the combo unit, she paid for the deposit. Come to find out that the clubhouse said that no, you can't have any inflatables here. So if we didn't take a deposit, that means we drove all the way out there. God forbid we actually had to set it up. And that we didn't get
nothing.
Yeah, we wouldn't have gotten paid anything. But because we had her pay a deposit,
and we showed up, we did what we said we were gonna do.
Yeah, so but she didn't read her thing.
We should get paid, right? So
we got $175 for that.
Yes.
Oh, insurance. We went through something. It was Next Insurance.
Yes.
Something basic. Just use like Next Insurance. It gets you approved with the city. So like we were approved with the city, we were approved with the county because of our insurance. Like there's people that spend thousands of dollars on bounce house insurance, and you really don't need to spend that much at all. Just go through a basic thing like Next Insurance. And then we also had waivers. So there's plenty of waivers that you guys can find online that has everything that you need legally. And then, you know, just change a couple things and boom, there you go. You have everybody sign waivers. They're usually pretty good people that, you know, obviously judge people's character, you know, when you meet them.
Yeah.
Charge fair prices.
And just tell them the rules. Say, hey, no food, no shoes. You know, just let them know. Like, if you break these rules, you're going to pay this fee. And you don't want to pay that fee.
And then nobody wants to pay the fee. So then we always would show up. And granted, we cleaned everything, but everything was pretty much clean by the time that we got there anyways.
So if you just let people know, hey, these are the rules. And if you break the rules, you're going to pay this. People are going to take care of
your
stuff.
Yeah, because people don't want to pay extra.
Exactly. Those are some pretty much basic tips to get started. Now, we do want to let you guys know that we exited the business. We sold it. We flipped it. We made a profit. We sold everything for $5,500.
Yeah.
Mind you, we spent about $300 for everything.
$3,000.
And Yeah, $3,000 for everything. But we ended up selling everything in total for $5,500, and we made our money back, and we gained the experience of it all. But as we were doing it, I mean, you can even see our facial expressions in the vlog. We were not enjoying it.
We tried our best. So, like, man, we're making a video. We have to, like, keep it together. But, man, it gets hot. Yeah. Those things are heavy. We're not very big people. I'm 4'11". What are you, 5'5"?
5'3".
No
shoes, 5'3". I mean, you put some sneakers on me, I'm 5'5". But really, I'm 5'3", y'all.
And, so, we're strong, okay? Tiny but mighty. But, I mean, those things, they weigh hundreds of pounds. So, it definitely takes a toll on you. And then just having to set it up and then go back there. I mean, it's honestly great. If you have kids and you just want to get one bounce house, one, it saves you money on the birthday parties. Two, you can rent it out to your friends and family and stuff like that and just do backyard parties. And then it makes its money back.
Yeah.
That's probably what I would recommend it.
Or you could leverage other people and pay them. Yeah. And we got into that, too. But, to be honest, I didn't want to continue to grow the bounce house business and depend on people, because if people I depend on couldn't show up, then I had to do the work. And mind you, we already have a furniture flipping business, which, if you haven't seen our couch flipping video, watch that,
check that out.
And I teach boxing. I'm a personal trainer, and that's what I do mainly. And my business for boxing has been exploding, so therefore I'm like, I gotta work on my days off. I ain't really trying to do that, you feel me? Because my job is already very physically demanding. So that's why we decided to exit the business and sell it. So here you go, guys. If you guys want to get into the business, I will say it can be pretty lucrative. But honestly, I recommend furniture flipping because you can make a lot more money with less time.
We're definitely super grateful for the experience, and honestly, glory to God that we found the deals that we did. But honestly, it was just his favor. There was no luck, it was all God. So we're super grateful that we got to experience it, we got to do it together. Would I do it again? Absolutely not. But it was fun, and we got a YouTube video out of it. If you guys have watched this entire video to the end, make sure you go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Go ahead and hit subscribe, make sure you turn on the notification bell, because we are being consistent with releasing videos. And yeah, guys, stay tuned. And thank you. We love you guys.
Bye. God bless.